First American craft in decades to land on the moon is just minutes away from touching down.
That's right. Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heiler has been watching it all unfold from the Kennedy Space Center and joins us live right now. So where exactly is the lunar lander right now?
Well, history delayed a little. It was supposed to touch down at 5:30, but mission managers at Intuitive Machines decided to take another lap, to take another orbit around the moon to position it in a better spot to look at more data. And that is supposed to happen now in just about 20 minutes. In about 10 minutes, it's going to start its powered descent.
And liftoff. Go SpaceX, go IM-1 and the Odysseus lunar lander.
For the last week, the Odysseus craft has traveled over 600,000 miles. Now it will be carrying out the delicate landing maneuver with many factors and steps at play. It'll use cameras and lasers to track its approach and onto its landing spot in a small crater near the lunar south pole. Its engine will be firing constantly to slow it down for a soft landing, the first American craft to do this since Apollo 17 in 1972. The IM mission, part of NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services, or CLPS, to build science and understanding of the moon's surface ahead of coming Artemis missions that will ultimately return humans to the moon.
For this specific delivery, we have about six NASA payloads on there. And we're testing all sorts of technologies that are going to feed into our Artemis program when we're sending astronauts, you know, in a few more years.
But just before it touches down, something called Eagle Cam will be deployed, dropping to the surface to record as Odysseus lands, providing a third-person view made by students at Embry-Riddle University.
Hopefully, we can study the plume data, so we'll have a lot of data from the plume of the lander. We want to see how the lander actually landed. And if everything goes, you know, smoothly, the ideal goal is that we take this amazing video of a lander landing.
And that will be studied for the more landings to come and ultimately a base on the moon.
And we're just minutes away to see if all that goes out perfectly and once again having an American presence on the moon. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.